In this video, I came up with 5 essential tips that you need to know before uploading your next photo on Facebook, because you need to take care of a few details besides the guidelines offered by the platform. I will also give you the best settings to use when you upload a new cover for your business page or personal profile, so let's start. There's a constant discussion about the Facebook compression for images. Before doing this tutorial, I made lots of tests by uploading the same image at different resolutions and compression values, trying to find a good balance between all the settings. Also, I tried to respect the Facebook guidelines to create the perfect cover for pages and personal profiles, trying to avoid compression issues and artifacts, especially when using text on a solid background. So here are my 5 tips. Tip number 1, you need to resize your image. If you do this at the recommended Facebook values, you will honor the system and the compression will not kick in so hardly. Facebook recommends a resolution of 720 pixels or 960 pixels or 2048 pixels on the width of the photo. Do this proportionally by making sure this icon is active and you're good to go. If you upload your resized image to Facebook, the system will not touch it in terms of resolution, which is a good thing. Tip number 2, if needed, go to Image, Mode, and choose 8-bit. This will make your image size much smaller in the end. Tip number 3, make sure you are using the sRGB profile, which is the standard red, green, and blue profile. Let's say your photo is in the Adobe RGB profile. You can check this by going to Edit, Assign Profile. Make sure you open this drop-down, your profile, and choose sRGB. Take a look at the image while I'm assigning the new profile. It makes a difference, and this is again a good thing because you are in control. You don't let Facebook to handle this situation for you. Tip number 4, use the Save for Web option by going to File, Export, Save for Web, or use the shortcut Ctrl+Alt+Shift+S or Cmd+Shift+S. I like this panel because it offers me tons of options. I can see in real time how much space will the final image take on the disk. I can also see a preview if I want to check the image for artifacts by enabling this tab up here. Tip number 5. For compression, the best results were the ones where I used 75%. This maintains a good balance between quality and the final size of the photo. Of course, you can use the Save for Web panel to resize your image, so you can enter here one of the recommended resolutions: 720, 960, or 2048. For this example, I will write in 960, save the file at 75%, and then upload it to my Facebook profile. If I open it, the image has details, it's sharp, I don't see banding in the sky or artifacts in this case, so I take this as a winner. As a bonus tip, let me show you how to export your cover photo for your business page. This is what Facebook recommends: 851 by 315 pixels, and the final image should have a maximum of 100 kilobytes. Let's imagine you have a red background, a logo, and some text. I wanted to choose this vibrant red because this is causing most of the problems when uploading a cover image. If I save it like this, using the classic Save As, I choose JPEG, click Save, choose maximum quality, and hit OK to save it, my final file will have 117 kilobytes. When I upload it to Facebook, it doesn't look good at all. Look at those artifacts. So here is how to fix this. Go to File, Export, Save for Web. I check again if my resolution is correct, and then I click on this little Optimize menu and choose Optimize for File Size. I enter 100 kilobytes here. I hit OK, the compression has been adjusted automatically, so I just press Save and upload it to my Facebook page. As you can see, the artifacts are gone and the image is clean and sharp. The file is under 100 kilobytes, so mission accomplished. Down in the description, you'll find the link for the official Facebook guidelines webpage. Make sure you check it out and don't forget to press the like on this video if you want to help me too. Also, leave a comment below and tell me if these methods worked out for you. I'm Chris, thanks for watching and see you next time.